Hello friends, happy yoga day. On this day, I want to tell you about yoga. I and my wife have been doing yoga for nearly 10 years. And we understand it now by practicing as a body-mind exercise. Because what it does is, you do this with your eyes closed. And when your eyes are closed, you can only see yourself. Yourself and your body, they are two different things. Let's understand this. And this distinction yoga will teach you very easily. So when your eyes are closed and you're doing the physical exercise, you can feel the connection between yourself and different parts of your body. So it puts the physical system into sync with your mind. In the same way as there is a high-speed internet connection connecting your device with distant objects. Secondly, I want to tell you is that this yoga improves your body immunity. It means the ability of your body system to fight infections. The human body has inbuilt systems to fight infections when they attack the body. And they can prevent you from becoming sick. Sometimes they are successful and sometimes they are not. When they are not, then you end up in hospital. So apart from improving body immunity, I must tell you also, many of the exercises in yoga are called pranayama. It means they are breathing exercises. How you breathe, different ways of breathing, taking breath in and breath out. These exercises as a part of yoga kriyas help your lung immunity. And I have found, particularly in the last 1.5 years of COVID, that we have been protected so far from COVID. I hope it stays that way. But I believe that it is something to do with the enhanced lung immunity that our lungs have developed because we have been doing yoga every day for 10 years. So it also helps in body immunity. And the third point is that it strengthens your mental ability. What do you mean by mental ability? You and your mind can be controlled by yourself. And there are many ills of the mind which are psychological in nature. Anger, depression, fear, anxiety, and man gets blown away by emotions. A practitioner of yoga learns how the mind can control these emotions and keep the mind distant from the actions around it. And that is a very valuable experience to have. And one more thing I must tell you. This is like a hidden gem. A hidden gem is one that you cannot see. Yoga is a hidden gem which our forefathers, our ancestors, the yogis, rishis, munis who have practiced it, they have learned by practicing. You can't learn it by reading, by watching a video, or by watching someone else do it, or hearing about it. You have to practice it to understand its meaning. It's like a very fine dish that is hidden away in a cover. And until you lift the cover and taste it, you will not know the taste of it. And finally, it is nothing new. It has been practiced by our forefathers, our ancestors for thousands of years. The earliest treatise written in Sanskrit of yoga is Patanjali's Yoga Shastra, Yoga Sutras. And it is perfected by the rishis, written down by some, and practiced over generations. So, if you want your well-being, your body and mind, and your that of your family, find a guru. Don't do it by yourself. Don't learn by watching a video or listening to an audio or reading a book. Find a local teacher of guru of yoga, and learn some asanas. And start anywhere. There are thousands of asanas. You start anywhere, and ultimately you will be connected to the real truth. And that is how I wish you a happy yoga day. Thank you.